Hello everyone. Today our topic is underwriting. What is underwriting? See, this is an underwriting chapter. It is meant for third semester BCom for Bangalore University and many other universities. Today I am going to teach you underwriting and some of the problems based on the underwriting. Okay, now let us see what is the meaning of underwriting. Underwriting is nothing but it is an agreement into by a company with one or more persons who are called as underwriters to take up the whole or a certain portion of unsubscribed shares. What is this unsubscribed shares? See, unsubscribed means unsold shares. The company which has to sell to the public, where the company cannot sell it, they are appointing one or more persons as an underwriters. Now, who is an underwriter? An underwriter is a person who undertakes the responsibility of subscribing or selling the shares to the public on behalf of the company. See, what is the benefit for the underwriters? See, the benefit for the underwriters is they get commission. That is, they get underwriting commission. How much they get commission? See, they get 5% on shares which they sold, which will be paid on issue price of the share. See, if I am issuing the share at 10 rupees, then I'll be getting 5% on 10 rupees as a commission. If I am selling a debenture, then I am getting 1/2%, that is 2.5% as a commission. So it's very clearly saying that underwriter is a person who undertakes the responsibility or obligation of selling the shares to the public on behalf of the company. That means the company gives the responsibility and the underwriters will take the responsibility. They sell on behalf of the company. What in case if the underwriters undertaken some number of shares to sell, if they could not able to subscribe or sell, what is the position of a company? See, it is an agreement. In this agreement, if the underwriter does not sell any shares, the underwriters themselves have to buy all those shares. This is a condition. So, andre illi underwriters avaru eshtu shares na nanu mark kodtini anta helirtare ashtu shares na mark agilla anta helidre ulidirthakanta ella shares annu kuda company ne purchase madbekagutte. I mean underwriters se purchase madbekagutte. So that is an agreement by a company between one or more underwriters. So they'll take up the responsibility of selling the shares. This is what the meaning of underwriting. Now we have discussed about who is an underwriter, underwriting commission. Now there are some types of underwriting. See, the types of underwriting is complete underwriting. What is this complete underwriting? Complete underwriting is very simple. If the company is issuing, say for example, 1 lakh shares to the public, and if these 1 lakh shares have been underwritten by, responsibilities taken by 2 or more underwriters, they undertake complete 1 lakh shares which are issued by the company. That is called as complete underwriting. Then what is partial underwriting? Partial underwriting means when the company issues 1 lakh shares and only a part of those 1 lakh shares have been subscribed by the company and underwriters, the remaining shares will be taken up by the company. Andre iga 1 lakh shares issue madidre, suppose underwriters bari 75,000 tagondidru, in 25,000 yaro company ne sell madutte, adanna we call it as partial underwriting. Then firm underwriting. Firm underwriting means what? Firm underwriting is nothing but there are a certain number of shares where the underwriters themselves committed to buy from the company. The remaining shares will be sold to the company or subscribed to the to the public. Andre artha firm underwriting andre very simple like helbeku andre ಈಗ ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಅನ್ನೋರು 20,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ. ಆದ್ರೆ ಕಂಪನಿಗೆ ಅವರೇ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಕಮಿಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಸರ್ ಈ 20,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 5,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ನಾವೇ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಏನು ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ನಾವೇ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದನ್ನೇ ನಾವು ಫರ್ಮ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಮಿಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ದ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ದೆಮ್ಸೆಲ್ ದೇಲ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಫರ್ಮ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್. Then marked and unmarked applications or forms. What is marked forms? See, when there are 2, 3, 4 underwriters are there,
the company wants to know who has sold, which an underwriter have sold, how many number of shares. So in order to identify the number of shares which is sold by the underwriters, the company will ask all the underwriters to put one stamp or seal which is each underwriter sold, so that the company can easily find out how many forms have been sold by each underwriter. See, if any applications or the forms which is not marked by any underwriter, that applications or that forms will be called as unmarked. Generally, unmarked applications are sold by the company directly. All of you got it? So it's a easy chapter where you get 22 marks out of 17 marks. Okay, now let us solve some of the questions based on underwriting. See, this is a question which is asked in the year 2008. It is asked in the year 2008 for 6 marks. See, this is a question based on partial underwriting. It is not complete underwriting, partial underwriting. See, how to identify whether it is a complete underwriting or a partial underwriting. I'll show you now. See, I'll read out this question, then only you will understand. See, Manasa Limited issued 20,000 equity shares of rupees 100 each. And the issue was underwritten as follows. See, the company is issuing 20,000 shares and there are 3 underwriters, A, B and C. These people have taken 30%, 30% and 20% as a responsibility to sell on behalf of the company. And applications for 15,000 shares were received by the company in all. That means in total, out of 20,000 shares which are company has issued, the applications were received only 15,000 shares. Now let us see how to solve this question. We need to find out the liability of underwriter. What is the liability? How many number of shares the underwriters have not sold, not subscribed? How many shares which have left out with the underwriters which has unsold? That is what we need to find out now. Now for this, if you take 30% A is undertaken, 30% B is undertaken and 20% C is undertaken. If you take the total, 30 plus 30 is 60, 60 plus 20 is 80. See, it is an incomplete or a partial underwriting. If he would have taken another 40%, definitely it would have 100%. But here, ABC is taken only 80%. What about the remaining 20%? The remaining 20%, the company itself is taken the responsibility to sell to the public. Now, how to find out? See, we have to prepare a statement showing liability of underwriters. Liability of underwriters. See, there are A, B and C underwriters are there. A is taken 30%, B is taken 30%, C is taken 20%. Now, the ratio is 3:3:2. Now, the remaining 20%, who is giving? The company is taking it up. Company is taking up 20%. Now, 20, 30, 50, 50 plus 50 is 100. Now, we need to find out the liability. So, first let us take gross liability. What is this gross liability? Gross liability means how many number of shares each underwriters have undertaken before selling to the public. So now 20,000 into 20% is 4,000 shares. 30% of 20,000 is 6,000. Here 6,000. Here 4,000. So 4, 6, 10. 10 plus 10, 20. Now from this, we need to find out how many number of shares which have sold or subscribed by the underwriters. Here in this question, it is not at all given. That means the entire 15,000 shares which are received by the company, which is sold by the company itself, and no underwriter have sold not even a single share. Now we need to understand that this 15,000 shares were received by the company, is sold by the company directly, and no underwriter have sold anything. Illi tilkolbekagirodiste underwriters 30 30 20
ರೇಷನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವರು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಹೌದಾ ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ 30 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 20 80 ಇನ್ನು 20% ಯಾರು ಕಂಪನಿನೇ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಕಂಪನಿ ಸೇರ್ಕೊಂಡು 3 ಜನ ಸೇರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮಾಡಿರೋ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಂದ್ರೆ 15,000 ಈ 15,000 ಈ 15,000 ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕಂಪನಿನೇ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ನಮ್ಗೆ ಈ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಬಿಸಿ ಎಸ್ಎಸ್ ಮಾರಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅನ್ನೋ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ಎಬಿಸಿ ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 100% ಗ್ಯಾರಂಟೀಡ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಇನ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ 15,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಅನ್ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ದಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಹೌದಾ ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಈ 15,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ನ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಅನ್ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಸೊ ಈಗ ಅನ್ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ 15,000 ಇದೆ ಇದು ಯಾರು ಮಾರಿರೋದು ಕಂಪನಿ ಮಾರಿರೋದು ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಕಂಪನಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅವ್ರು ಮಾರಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು 4,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಬಟ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ 15,000 ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ 9,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ನೌ ಎ ಬಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇವನ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಶೇರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕೀಪಿಂಗ್ ಆಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೌ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದ ಕಂಪನಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ 9,000 ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಕಂಪನಿ ಟು ಎಬಿಸಿ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ 3:3:2 ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕೀಪಿಂಗ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೊ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇವನ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಶೇರ್ ನೌ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ದಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಇನ್ ದ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಆಫ್ 3:3:2 3 + 3 = 6 6 + 2 = 8 ಸೊ ನೌ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ 9,000 ಇಂಟು 3/8 ಓಕೆ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೀನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ನೌ 9,000 ರುಪೀಸ್ ದಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ 4,000 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಟು ಸೆಲ್ ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ 15,000 ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ 9,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದಿ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಬಿಸಿ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ 3:3:2 ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ 9,000 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಮಾರಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅದನ್ನ ಎಬಿಸಿಗೆ ಅವ್ರ ರೇಷಿಯೋನಲ್ಲಿ ಹಂಚ್ತೀವಿ ಸೊ ಏನ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಅದು 3:3:2 ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ 9,000 × 3/8 9,000 × 3/8 9,000 × 2/8 ಸೊ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ 3,375 2,250 ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನು ಉಳಿದಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ನೆಟ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಎಷ್ಟಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಕಂಪನಿ ಎ ಏನು ಇರಲ್ಲ ಕಂಪನಿ ಬಿ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 2,625 ಬಿ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 2,625 ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 1,750 ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸೆಲ್ ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಕುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸೆಲ್ ಇಟ್ ದೇರ್ ನೆಟ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬೈ ಇಟ್ ಸೊ ಇದು ಮಾರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅವರೇ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ 6 marks ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಓಕೆ ನೌ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ 1 more ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಫಾರ್ 6 marks ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ 2009 ಸೀ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪಾರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಐ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಸೊ ದಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ 20,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ₹10 each ದೀಸ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಬೈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೈ ಬೈ 10,000 and 6,000 ಸಿ 10,000 + 6,000 ಈಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ 16,000 ಬಟ್ ದ ಕಂಪನಿ ಈಸ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ 20,000 ಸೊ ದ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ 4,000 ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಇನ್ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಟು ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ನೌ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೊ ಟೋಟಲ್ 16,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ದ ಕಂಪನಿ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ 16,000 ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೈ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ನೌ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಆರ್ how many shares the company has sold or subscribed. So to that we need to calculate unmarked applications, because A is given marked applications. So 16,000 is including marked and unmarked. Since we know the marked applications, we need to calculate unmarked applications. Let me tell you how to calculate this. See, calculation of unmarked. Okay. So the total applications received is 16,000. In this, marked forms is 2,400 plus 600 shares, that is 3,000 shares. The remaining 13,000 shares have called unmarked applications. Now these unmarked applications, we need to show it in the statement. In this statement, he is asking show net liability of underwriters. For that we need to prepare a statement. How to prepare? Statement of net liability of underwriters. See, we have X and Y underwriter. Along with that, the company is also selling directly. See, X is taken 10,000 to subscribe. Y is taken 4,000 to subscribe. 10,000 and 6,000. I'm sorry. 10,000 and 6,000. 10 plus 6 is 16,000. But the company issued 20,000. The company has taken 4,000 to sell. So this is called gross liability. This is called gross liability of underwriters. Now I am making columns also so that it becomes easy for you to draw. In the examination, you can prepare like this. From this, we need to, first step is, we need to minus unmarked applications. See, in the question, nowhere is given unmarked applications. We have calculated unmarked applications. Who is sold is, the company directly sold. See, always unmarked is, the company has sold directly. So 13,000, I'll put it in the company's column. And X and Y does not sold, subscribed any shares. Now, this company sold excess of 9,000. See, they have taken 4,000 to subscribe. But how many shares they have subscribed? 13,000 shares they have subscribed. Means, excess 9,000 shares they have subscribed. Now, I'll take 10,000 here and 6,000 here. What is the next step is, the excess of company subscription has to be given to X and Y in their gross liability ratio. What is the gross liability ratio? 3, 0, 3, 0 cancel. 10 is to 6. 10 is to 6, we can call it as 5 is to 3. 2 5s are, 2 3s are. Now, if I am taking excess of company distributed to X and Y in 5 is to 3 ratio, that means 9,000 into 5 by 8 and 3 by 8. So 5 by 8 comes to 5,625 and this comes to 3,375. So now this is minus, now this is plus, and the companies becomes nil. Now this one is 3, 9 minus 5 is 4, 2, 5, 6, 2, 2, 6, 2, 5. Now this is the balance which is available. From this, what is the next step we have to do is, we have to minus marked applications. See, marked applications which is given in the question, X is sold 2,400, Y is sold 600. So X is sold 2,400, Y is sold 600. Now the net liability of underwriters, net liability of underwriters is 1,975 and 2,025. So now this is the answer for us. So that means X and Y, they yet to sell 1,975 and 2,025. Fine, I hope all of you understood. Please subscribe my channel Sai Study Circle and don't forget to press the button bell icon. Okay, if you have any questions, please let me know. Thank you.